Hey fragrance lovers, how are ya? Welcome back to my channel. I'm gonna tell you right now, this is gonna be for people that love Christmas. In my collection, I have fragrances that remind me big time of the Christmas season. Alright, and I'll get into why that is. But these are the fragrances that when I smell them, instantly I'm jettisoned into a whole chestnuts roasting on an open fire type thing. Hope you guys enjoy this video, and this fragrance journey starts right now. Let's go. Alright people, let's go ahead and get this started. I'm going to apologize right now for my gum chewing. I know it's uncouth, but whatever. Anyway, let's jump right in. Coming out of the house of Bordesay of the Victorious, this is as rock. Christmassy, of course. Spicy, cinnamon, and woods. Very, very nice fragrance. 25 as rock. Alright, and at number 24 from the house of Chantecaille, this is Kalimantan. Basically, what you're going to get here is burning woods, very spicy, cozy. Again, really nice fragrance. Kalimantan, Chantecaille, moving on. All right, and number 23 is coming out of the house of Mask Milano. This is Tango. And what you're going to have here is a lot of spices, like cumin, cardamom, cinnamon. And then you're going to get that ambery vibe. This is a warm and snuggly fragrance. I mean, it's not a skin scent. You know, it's going to jump off the skin, but once it starts to calm down, very warm and cozy, snuggler, all right? Once again, Tango, Mask Milano. Number 22 is coming out of the house of Imaginary Authors. This is Cape Heartache. Basically, what you got here is, this is Christmas by the ocean, all right? When it's wicked, wicked cold outside. The tree line is behind the beach for whatever reason. And in that tree line is a bunch of pine trees, fir trees, whatever. There's your Christmas. Once again, Cape Heartache, the house, Imaginary Authors. Next in at 21 is from the house of Ormond Jean. This is Tolu. And what gives this its Christmassy kick? Tolu Balsam, Olibanum, Amber, and Sweet Tonka. Very, very Christmassy right here. Once again, Tolu. All right, number 20 is coming out of the house of Tiziana Terenzi. This is Porpora. It's a very jammy rose with cinnamon and chestnuts. There you have it, people. Christmas in a bottle. All right, coming in at number 19 is coming out of the house of Bordesay of the Victorious. Good luck trying to find this one, people. You're going to be hard-pressed to do it, but it is Christmassy, and it is called Fortuitous. And it's going to be almondy with cherries and fir trees. Absolutely phenomenal fragrance. And again, very Christmassy. All right. At the 18th spot is from the house of Francesca Bianchi. And this is called the Dark Side. This is just straight up smoke and honey. All right. Wicked Christmassy right here. You smell this, you're going to be jettisoned to like Christmas morning. Once again, the Dark Side. All right, and 17 is coming from the house of Initio Parfum. This is Oud for Greatness. Oud wood, nutmeg. There you have it. That's all I can say. This fragrance, you know what? I'm not going to say anything except this fragrance right here inspired me for another video that's coming soon. That's all I'm saying. Once again, 17, Oud for Greatness. Moving on. 16, everybody knows it. If you don't, you're living under a rock. This is from the house of Armouage, and it is called Lyric. This is deep, dark, smoky roses. Just what you want to smell on Christmas morning, I think. Believe it or not, you might look at it and say, yeah, I don't know about the whole Christmas thing, but it does remind me of Christmas, and that's it, and that's all. Once again, 16, Lyric, moving on. All right, 15, from the house of Profumum Roma. This is Patchouli. Yeah. I know what you're thinking. I say this every single time this fragrance comes up in my videos. if you're looking at it and you're looking at the name and you're thinking,
it's going to be from the Woodstock era.
It's going to smell like a hairy, hippie flower child. Forget about it. That's not it at all. This is a very, very deep, dark amber fragrance. The patchouli is not a main player. It stays in the background, lays in the cut. This is very Christmassy. Once again, Profumo Roma Patchouli. 14 is coming out of the house of Eldo. This is Experimentum Crucis. Spiced apple cider with honey and woods. Bang. Doesn't get much more Christmassy than that, my friends. Once again, Eldo. Experimentum Crucis. 13 is coming out of the house of Matriarch. And this is called The Longing. Very dark. This fragrance will literally slice through the cold air. Big time. It is amazing. A buttery leather smoke bomb. Like I said, Christmas in a bottle. There you have it again. The Longing. Moving on to 12. All right, I'm trying to, you know, get through these quickly. Number 12 is from the house of Tiziana Terenzi. This is Tabit. This is got, I mean, this is like eating a jam sandwich in a pine tree filled wood line on a cold winter's day. Yeah, again, Christmas. Tabit at 12, moving on to 11. 11 spot coming out of the house of Roja. This is Fetish. This smells like dad's biker leather jacket with tons of resinous smoke and spices with a massive animalic undertone, or should I say overtone. See what I did there? Anyway, very, very hardcore fragrance, long-lasting, very, very powerful. Any more than two sprays, bleh, people start getting choked out. You know what it is? Fetish. Moving on. All right, we are now cracking the top 10 of my 25 most Christmassy smelling fragrances in my collection. And this is coming out of the house of La Tessin Parfumeur. This is Noir Exquis. Picture this. I know I sound like Sophia Petrillo. Picture this. Early Christmas morning, mom made pancakes with a warm maple syrup, all right? This is before you start opening presents, all right? While dad is drinking coffee. In the oven is roasting chestnuts. Bingo. Bada beep, bada boop. Doesn't get any more Christmassy than that, people. Again, you want to talk about Christmas in a bottle? This is it right here. Once again, Noir Exquis. All right, and coming in at the number 9 position, we have from the house of Armouage, Epic. You know what it is. If you don't, get out from underneath that rock. Huge pine forest in like freaking Montana on a wicked cold Christmas morning. Boom, there it is. Once again, Epic from Armouage. Number 8 is coming out of the house once again of Bordesea the Victorious. This is Notorious. Basically, what you have here, people, is chocolate, smoke, cinnamon, leather, and yeah, like toasting s'mores, basically, what you have here. Once again, Notorious at number 8, moving on. At the number 7 position from the house of Orto Parisi, this is Terroni. I reviewed it, check it out. Basically, it's hellfire in a bottle. It smells just like burning embers. I mean, literally, this is like fire and brimstone, volcanic ash, smoke. It's freaking delicious. Terroni, Orto Parisi, moving on. Next up is number 6, and this is coming out of the house of Tom Ford. Do not try to find this. It ain't going to happen. If you're lucky enough to find this fragrance, you're going to be paying a mortgage to get it into your possession. Don't waste the time. I mean, I think it's a phenomenal fragrance, but I know people are going to be charging probably way up in the hundreds for this. Forget it. But it is the most incredible amber fragrance ever. Amber Absolute. It's EOL, so again, you can't get it. Don't try. But if you ever want to know what it smells like, come to me. I'll spray it, and you'll flip. Moving on. Number 5 is coming out of the house of Armouage. Again, everybody knows this. Everybody calls it the Blue Beast. And quite deservedly so. This is an absolute monster. Original formulation right here, guys. Interlude. You spray this and you are in Christmas. And you, I don't care if you're standing on the shores of friggin' Clearwater Beach. You spray this, you're instantly transported to 5 degrees Fahrenheit, snow everywhere up to your balls on Christmas Day. Very smoky, very spicy. Amazing. Interlude, Armouage, next. All right, this one is coming out of the house of Roja. This is Creation E. This is like, smells like your father is smoking a pipe on Christmas night while drinking a sifter of cognac. Done. My wife hates everything. She's like Mikey from that Life commercial, but she loves this. Why? Because it smells like tobacco and alcohol. Figure that out. Anyway, once again, Creation E from Roja. Moving on to number three. This is coming out of the house of Zerjoff. This is called Shun Coin. This smells like you're opening up presents on Christmas morning as a kid. One of your gifts is a big old thing of Play-Doh. Yep. Play-Doh in a bottle. Very, very Christmassy. Shun Coin, Zerjoff. Moving on. All right, this is at the number two position, and I know a lot of you might be shocked by the fact that this even made the list, but to me, very, very Christmassy. From the house of Guerlain, this is Bois d'Amini, all right? Spices, smoke, you sense a theme here? Spices and smoke is definitely the, you know, the notes du jour, specifically where Christmas is concerned. You have spices and smoke, it's going to me anyway, it's going to smell like Christmas. Once again, from the house of Guerlain, Bois d'Amini. Moving on to the most Christmassy smell and fragrance in my entire collection. And if you guys know me, before you even see number one, I guarantee you, you already know what it is. Stand by.
Number one, 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 one.
And here we go. The most Christmassy smell and fragrance I have ever smelled in my life. From the house of Profumum Roma. This is Arso. Basically, what you have here, guys, is burning Christmas trees. Everybody loves this fragrance. It will literally remind you of Christmas, even if you're in the middle of July and it's 95 Fahrenheit. You spray this on Christmas Day. Done. That is it, people. My top 25 most Christmassy smelling fragrances ever. My next review is soon. I'll talk to you later. Oh, by the way, I hope you guys have a very Merry Christmas and a happy, safe New Year. And I'll talk to you later.